hopes and dreams are just as real. The threat, the drama, the excitement, it's all still here. Stars will shine. Heroes will emerge. The glory of winning a championship will be as meaningful as ever. Things are looking up, Minnesota. Enjoy the tournaments together.
It's magical, it's mystical, it's the Minnesota Boys State Hockey Tournament, AA State Championship tonight, undefeated Lake Belsall against the Eden Prairie Eagles. Johnny Paul, Minnesota's Mr. Hockey, and former state champion himself. When you look at this game, it is so evenly matched all the way across.
Yeah, they're the two best teams in the state. Between the two of them, they're 40-1. They got high-powered offenses, good goaltender. This is going to be a great game.
Eden Prairie's lost the last two title games. How much do you think that sits in their craw right now?
I'm sure it doesn't make them very happy. The two things that I think are most important for Eden Prairie tonight are, number one, they're going to need some depth. They cannot keep relying on their top line. And number two, this goes for both teams. I think the penalty kill is going to be very important because these power plays are so lethal. We really got to pay attention to the penalty kill tonight.
And Lake Belsall just bolted out of that locker room. They're undefeated. They beat Maple Grove, who put on a show here last night, so they know they can skate toe-to-toe with these guys.
Yeah, and we talked about this a little last night. Lake Belsall is undefeated, yet they're the 3 seed. So I think they, again, can kind of use that no respect card and come out and show that they are the best team in the state.
You don't need a lot of motivation at this point, do you?
You shouldn't.
All right, let's meet the starter, send down the PA announcer, Jim Carroll. Jim?
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the 77th Annual Minnesota State High School League Boys Hockey Tournament. Tonight's AA state title game features the champions of Section 1 with a record of 20-0-2, the Lakeville South Cougars. Against the champions of Section 2 with a record of 21-2, the Eden Prairie Eagles. Now let's meet the starting lineups. In goal for Lakeville South, senior number 30, Cody Tyson. On defense, senior number 21, Jack Malinsky. His defensive partner, junior number 25, Mason Johnson. The left wing is sophomore number 4, Tanner Ludke. The right wing, senior number 9, Cam Bakke. And the center is senior number 19, Cade Aaronholz. The assistant coaches are Corey Campbell and Lee Engstrom. Head coach is Yanni Giebelhalmi. Starting in goal for Eden Prairie, senior number 30, Zach Hayes. On defense, senior number 24, Cam Langfels. His offensive partner, senior number 27, Luke Middlestad. At left wing, senior number 8, Drew Holt. The right wing, junior number 43, Jackson Blake. And the center is senior number 11, Carter Batchelder. The assistant coaches are Paul Ranheim and Tom Gertis. Head coach is Lee Smith. Here are tonight's game officials on the lines. Jamie Steinberg and Drew Walters. Your referees are Todd Plattner and Todd Skaya.
And the boys' hockey season comes to a close. It has all come down to this. Along with Lou Nanny, I'm Jim Erickson. Lakeville South and Eden Prairie. What is going to be the difference in this one, Lou, from the team that's going to walk away here as a champion, the team that's going to walk out of here as the runner-up?
Well, it depends on the secondary scoring. You know, the first lines of each team are powerful, but there's such a difference. 55 goals between Eden Prairie's top line and the next closest. Only 29 for Lakeville South. So secondary scoring is key. Will somebody be there to answer the bell?
All right, let's break it down game and team by team here with the keys to the game.
Well, Lakeville South can't take penalties because we saw Eden Prairie's terrific power play. And Eden Prairie's got to clear the front of the net and make certain their goaltender could see the shot because Lakeville Celtics really capitalized on screenshots and scrambles around the net in the last two games.
We get to see the dark uniforms for Lakeville South here for the first time in the state tournament as the lower-seeded team. Eagles, the number one seed, and Cougars at number three. It's Eden Prairie in the white uniforms. In this championship game, these teams have played in four state tournaments here in this decade, 2017, 19, 20, and now here in 21. So they're very familiar with each other. The starting goal is brought to you by your local Holiday Station stores.
Well, just look at the similarity in statistics and goals against and saves on both these goaltenders. Tyson for Lakeville South and Hayes for Eden Prairie. Very, very close.
Tyson getting the start in all three games here for Lakeville South, basically all season long and even through the section playoffs. Coach Kibuhame was flip-flopping between Dahlmeier and Tyson. But he settled on the senior here during the state tournament. It's been a good decision. He's played well and got his team in the state championship game. Jackson Blake, five assists in that semifinal. He recovered from that one.
Really, yeah. Boy, that was amazing. You know what was amazing, wasn't it? It was so tight for so long, and then all of a sudden, we got three goals by each team in a very short period of time.
Holt, quickly, forced wide, saved by Tyson. Rebound back over for Langenberger. He comes down, comes away with it. Now he comes into the backhand, saved by Tyson. Rebound in the slot, and up and out of the zone. Lupke clears. It should be enough for icing here, and it is called and whistled against Lakeville South.
Well, here's a good hit by Middlestead. You see that? But boy, oh boy, did he very ever have a couple of good opportunities. First of all, you had Holt, and then right here you had Langbrenner. But Holt last night made an outstanding play in a win goal in overtime. He's had a tremendous tournament, and he started off again also in fire in this one, too.
Another faceoff win for Eden Prairie in the shot. Brown in the glove of Tyson will do it again.
One big thing that Lakeville South was good at last night was faceoffs, especially Aaron Holt, number 19. He won 28 faceoffs last night, two that resulted directly in goals.
This time, Lakeville South again gets to it. Again, Aaron Holtz, Lupke, and Bakke is their top line. And Eden Prairie will dump it in. Tyson sweeps it around. Pitching in and keeping that puck in at the near side there. Spineberg. And Lakeville South able to clear it up and out. They'll come down the wall. This is Willis, who's had a nice tournament of two goals and 3 points total. The lake goes south. Brett Johnson, the defenseman.
That line has had a really good turn for Lakeville South.
Back on the Eagles. And the son Luloff intercepted, and the Cougars send it all the way back down. Middlestad tracks it down. Wasn't going to be enough for icing. Quick change here for Lakeville South. Middlestad trying to find an opening here. That's a good, quick stick joining the play. Jet England. And it comes back to the Cougars. Long breakout, Stone King comes in, shot, save made, Hayes, rebound to the far side, back into the corner, and the Eagles will track it down there and get started the other way with Oliver Jorgensen, circling back here for the Eagles.
Eden Prairie coming out of the zone very well this far, taking her time, they're very poised, they move the puck, they take a look, not making any turnovers thus far. Lakeville South is going to have to try and find a way to put pressure on it.
And Langfels for John Hartle. Back to Langfels. Stone King. Teams exchanging possession here, and it flips up over the glass and out of play. Today's closed captioning brought to you by Minnesota Touchstone Energy Cooperatives. Together we save.
Well, one of the keys also is going to be who keeps their gap to narrow. And right now, it's been Eden Prairie. They're not giving Lakeville South any room to operate in that neutral zone. The forwards and defense have got to be placed, you know, just feet apart so there's no room to cut in between them. And Lakeville South didn't have anything to look at just far in this game.
Holds up the wall, but held in. Malinsky, but only momentarily helped out by Langfels. Blake comes in. And Blake had five assists. Jackson Blake, a goal, five assists. A six-point game last night against Maple Grove. As here comes Blake. Loses the puck, pushed the other way, and this is Cam Bakke, their leader with 57 points, and he steers it, and will be covered by Hayes.
That's two really good first lines, and it's interesting to see both of these coaches are comfortable having their top line play against each other. Now, who's going to be better in these two lines? We'll see, but they each have big, big scoring potential, and we've seen them lead their teams in this tournament thus far.
Here Here's Aaron Holtz, who did so well in the draws last night. This time, kind of a battle there, won by Middlestat after they pulled it to the wall. Play quickly in transition. Backhands it to the backside, and Holtz is going down outside that far pipe, but could not get his stick on it.
A winning draw sometimes means your wing's got to get in there. Aaron Holtz actually won that for the wing yesterday in the zone.
And sometimes that's forgotten as Lake goes south. Centers on the side of the cage, back up to the point. To try to hold it in. That's Brett Johnson on that far side. Jackson Blake ends up with it. There are guys all over him, and he still maintains the puck and finds a way to keep it in the zone. And they go D to D. Coring a shot, almost trickled in on Tyson. Fighting. He's a guy that can win some battles, that Drew Holt. Good work ethic. Back up to the point, Coring. Back in low. It's Holt trying to make something happen here. Partial change. New player in on the change. Brown gets it, spins and fires, and he gets knocked down and blocked. Back to the point. Intercepted. It'll be Hockey the other way. Mr. Hockey finals. Hockey across the line. Trying to take up some time for a few from Hockey. And he's getting very jersey right back. And the shot has Feinberg off the block for Tyson.
Good shot by Feinberg there. This line is pretty easy. You think he'd come up with something because they've been really working hard and have had some opportunity.
D to D, Middlestat. Centers it up. Shot Langfeld's off the glass. The puck possession here by Eden Prairie. Cycling that puck around, looking for chances. And they've had a couple of looks. Shots are 7-2. Eden Prairie here to start the game. Middlestat again. Bodies out in front in the air. Feinberg tracks it down. And then from behind, a stick down on it.
Douglas Bruce are getting through, and boy, he can go into a screen. Dean Perry's giving him a call to go from him, taking the time here, you know. Get the front of the net clear.
Puck deflected on a play, our first timeout of this first period. No score, Class A championship.
Employee-owned City Auto Glass, the experts in auto glass replacement, repair, and recalibration.
It's high school hockey tourney time. Once again, we are so proud to help bring this great Minnesota tradition to you. Good luck, teams, and enjoy the games. First National Bank of Coleraine, member FDIC, and equal housing lender.
Here, in this place, a game like nowhere else, where team is everything. Together, we push, we strive, and sometimes we fall. But here, adversity is an opportunity to make teamwork count when it matters most. Because together, we own this ice. This is orthopedics and sports medicine like nowhere else.
Whether it's business, a family vacation, or a couple on a summer getaway, the Timberlake Lodge is the perfect place to stay. Offering a variety of room types, restaurant and bar, and your day with a hot tub and fun in the Grand Splash Pool. Timberlake Lodge, Grand Rapids.
Live TV are brought to you by the Greater Twin Cities Honda Dealers, proud sponsor of Minnesota Youth Hockey.
Tweet us your tournament photos using hashtag tourneys on 45TV, and you may be named the DQ fan of the game. DQ, happy, tastes good.
Well, every time you get a commercial, you know that the top lines are going to be coming out here, which is to be expected. One thing we got to watch for, though, is how much the second and third line play for Lakeville South, and if they're able to give the top line a rest, because they certainly played this first line a lot in this tournament.
Here's the zone. He's got an open look, and then he got blocked right at the last moment. Hockey comes the other way. He's one on two with Langfels and Middlestat getting back. Langfels takes the body. Middlestat grabs the puck.
Our defense there has been outstanding.
Holtz, Blake, leaves it for Gatson, and he scores. He starts the game just like he finished last night. 1-0 game, Burley.
That's right, he got three last night. He starts it off here. And good play again by Holt. Holt with an outstanding tournament. He's had some good setups, and this was another one as he just drops that pass to Batchelder. And Batchelder puts it past the goaltender to give Eden Prairie outstanding player in this tournament. He just has been a force every time he's been on the ice.
Seven assists in the tournament, now eight with that one.
And it's not only the assists, Jim, it's how much he's controlled the puck and made plays and just, you know, caused so much to happen. He's having an outstanding season. By the way, when we look at both Batchelder and Aaron Holtz, they're going to be teammates in Colorado sometime. They're both going to Colorado College.
Batchelder getting his sixth goal of the tournament. He had the hat trick last night and gets going here, the Mr. Hockey finalist. And Eden Prairie is kind of control play. I should say kind of definitely has control play here the first 6 minutes, and it results in a goal. Now let's see if Lakeville South can pressure that. They do have the puck. Gunnarsson a shot in, bodies out in front. Hartle comes for Eden Prairie across the line. Tips it up ahead. Jorgensen ends up with it. Cycle game has been good here for Eden Prairie when they get down low in the corners. Arnold throws it out in front, thought about a wraparound, and then was able to keep it on his stick. And we've got a Lakeville South player going down to the ice. It's going to be a penalty. It's going to be on Oliver Jorgensen. It'll be a trip, and Lakeville South will get the first power play chance of the game.
Well, we're going to have another look at the goal. It's just a great play. We see the outlet pass coming, but watch. Blake has got such presence of mind when he gets a hold of that puck and he sees the man trailing him, drops it to Batchelder, he puts it away. And I take a look at the penalty right here, and I think that's what I thought looking at it first time. The guy just fell. He was not tripped, and unfortunately, for Eden Prairie, they're going to be playing shorthanded because of it.
And yourself
moved the puck on the power play around the outside of the lock, but didn't get many shots on them. As a matter of fact, the first power play they had, they didn't get any shots, and so they've got to try and take a little more from the blue line, especially. That was a good try by Malinsky. It seemed like it got deflected wide. He's looking at the Aramos. He's been a factor for the swing field, some team throughout the turn.
And he had 2 goals, 2 assists, 4 points last night. South was offside, so that's why they brought the faceoff outside of the offensive zone. Eden Prairie, a key faceoff win, sent the other way. Lakeville South will have to start deep in their zone. 14 minutes left to go in their power play. No pass. Forrest Blatt, he puts it right on the stick of Blake. A shorthanded with Batchelder. 2-on-1. Blake in over across through the crease. And missed wide.
You thought that maybe he would have just cut in front. As the defenseman drifted over to his right, he had the room to cut over, and he tried to pass instead.
Langer going to get it on his stick, poked away, then right back in the top line for Eden Prairie for the tournament. 9 goals, 14 assists, 23 points for the tournament. Overall, they have 170 points on the season. Eight-game team. They've had to come back in each of their games. They were trailing. They outplayed their opponents in the third period. In each of the games, they fell behind to Wayzata 2-0 last night. Lakeville South was able to come back and get that win and score 4 unanswered goals, 4 goals in the third last night.
You see Blake coming in, these guys open far, and he's looking at the goaltender, and they try to look him off to pass it across. He actually could have cut right in front of the forehand here, but you know, if you're going to pass that puck earlier, you're in a much better position, because Batchelder was in a spot where he could have received the pass and got a shot away.
Make it to Dom, a lot of bodies out front between that pass back out the center, dumped in again by Lakeville South.
One of the things he's very good very well is they bring their forward down low to help out around the net, and that's why they had to fight whatever for
Luloff to Brown, but it's offside.
You know, there's nothing like supporting your teammate on the ice to affect their game. Eden Prairie, well, both these teams do it, but Eden Prairie has done an outstanding job around the net. They let their goaltender see shots, they bring the forwards back, and they help the defenseman get out of the zone. And Eden Prairie, I think, is going to come out of the zone easier than anybody else in this tournament because of it.
Puck ends up in possession of the Lakeville South Cougars. Hockey, being shy of the red line. Did not whistle at icing as it goes to what may have been cast. And it goes all the way around, then back up to center, and then back in again by the Cougars. Langenbrunner takes it on a handoff, and his goaltender's after the lead. Pushes it ahead for Blake. Blake always looking to create. He finds Holt, and there's an empty net. Open net, yawning net, and it was blocked by a defender.
That was a terrific block. You're right, that was a wide open net. And Malinsky blocked that shot. What a play by Malinsky. A great passing plays. You'll see here, Blake across the hole to look at Malinsky right there with a great blocker. That puck was in the net. Right here, you take a look, and there's no way that that wasn't going in. Oh, Malinsky's had a terrific tournament for Lakeville South. He's reeled in a number of times here today. There's a good change by that team, a good change by this game. Well, that's really key to make good changes.
Line comes through center for Eden Prairie. They find the offensive zone. Brown in the blue line. Left angle with the referee. Riku Brown goes right back at it for Feinberg. Feinberg, Brown, and Luloff. The second line here for Eden Prairie could be a key tonight, as Lou mentioned in the opening of the broadcast.
Well, you know, Brown has done so many good things. He hasn't been on the fourth yet, but he's really had some outstanding moves in this tournament.
Long end wall, centering pass right up the slot. Brown finds it. Wasn't in a good position to take a shot, so Feinberg gets the rebound. Eden Prairie cycling game continues to be very impressive. Loose puck going down on the ice with Luloff. Couldn't get a shot off from a knee. Middlestad has it. He takes one from a wide angle outside the circle. That sails high off the glass, but Feinberg, and they maintain possession again here for Eden Prairie. They're changing with the puck in the offensive zone here.
Yeah, great forecheck. He needs pressure on. Able to get a change. He got some good chances, and there's another one.
Two big saves by Tyson. Back to Middlestad. They're applying the heat. The Eagles right now buzzing.
And I like that play by Middlestad. He tried to miss the net there. He wanted to play off the backboards. He just didn't get it.
Nice lob pass up ahead for Wells, and he crashes in. Penalty up and coming. That's as good of a lob pass up in the air that you're ever going to see, because it's hard for that play to stay onside. But it was a beauty, and Wells got a chance, and he draws a penalty.
And that was the guy that started Lakeville South for the first game when they were behind, as Wells. Takes a great play there. Excellent save by Hayes, as there's a slash and by Middlestad. Now you see the goaltender making an outstanding save in Maple Grove. Lakeville South will go on their second power play. What a good, I have to tell you, good play by both by Wells and by the goaltender. The goaltender had to come across making an outstanding save.
2:22 left to go in the first period. Shots are 10-6 in favor of Eden Prairie. Hank Bell's in his zone for Eden Prairie. Could not force it out. Bakke with position and possession. Cam Bakke all the way around. Still with it. This is where he started, and then he ties down to Lemke. Minute left to go in the period. 30 seconds left in the power play right now. Malinsky. Hand on his pass back to Malinsky. His wrist shot blocked. Luloff got in the way of that, and it goes into the benches. 23 seconds remaining in the power play.
Jim, you just mentioned when Bakke was going around, you said, oh, he's back where he started. And that's what happens so often, as we're going to look at that blocked shot that goes out of play right here. Too often, on the power play, puck here carries the puck to where he should be passing the puck. And it takes all that time. The puck moves faster than the player. So just move the puck. That's what gets the defense out of position. Keep moving that puck.
And Eden Prairie getting to the draw. That's why I love doing the games with you, Lou. I always learn something. Teaching us about the game. That's what it's all about. And that was, how would you grade that power play for Lakeville South here? Is it about to come to a close here? Didn't get as many offensive chances maybe as they would like.
They haven't done it. Many of them either.
Nice move in, Doms. He danced around a defender into the crease. Four ball scrambles. Action in the grease pan, and Zach Hayes saw it and covered it.
They helped by the defenseman there, and that's what you have to have. Both Langbrenner in front of the net and Jorgensen doing enough to get Hayes the time to freeze that puck. That's what Eden Prairie has done so well this year, is around the net supporting their goaltender. Now, you know, they've been in the playoffs the last 2 years in the finals here at state championship, haven't won. And you ask Lee Smith, what's the difference in this team? He said, my defense is better. This defense is the best one I've had in the last 2 years, so that's why he feels good about this team.
Yeah, Langfeld, Middlestad, Langenturner, there's some serious talent there. Two of them are Division I commits. Middlestad, Minnesota, Langenbrunner Harbor. There's the horn. 1-0 Eden Prairie through 17 minutes.
Well, it's a really good period for Eden Prairie because they're in the lead, but also because they have had to kill two penalties. You know, Lakefield South had the opportunities in a power play. Had they capitalized, it'd be a different game. But we're seeing what we expected. A tight game, good goaltending on both sides. And right now, shots on goal, Eden Prairie 10, Lakefield South 8. Score 1-0. So we're right where we expected to be with a tight game in the first period.
Only goal of the game, 5:56 of that first period. Carter Batchelder scoring once again. He ended it last night in overtime, and he got us started here today. And Eden Prairie, through one in the Class AA Championship game, loses 1-0 on 45 TV.
Hockey Power Play is driven by Kohler Chevrolet Buick GMC Cadillac. You're not just getting a car, you're getting Kohler.
Gartner, providing the Northland expert solutions in commercial heating, cooling, and temperature control systems. Bear in mind, Gartner is a proud sponsor of all Northland athletics.
TV. The tournaments on 45 TV are brought to you by Tria Orthopedics. For the athlete in all of us, there's Tria.
We began a defensive battle in the AA State Championship game. Eden Prairie with a 1-0 lead with 17 minutes of hockey to go. Earlier tonight, Gentry Academy took on Dodge County for the Single A Championship, and it was all Gentry, Johnny Paul.
Yeah, it was a one-sided affair from the very start. Gentry just had too much offense, too much skill. Roy Lamb did get his 10th goal of the tournament, which is an incredible feat. But as you said, Joe, it was Gentry from the get-go.
Yeah, they are undefeated. They've got talent up and down that lineup, and they have a lot of speed. And next year, they're probably going to be playing up in Double-A, which, of course, will make it interesting.
Yep, and it'll be interesting to see how many of those players come back and where their new players fit in. But you're right, they'll be a good team.
Okay, let's take a look at the Mr. Hockey candidates, because we've seen a lot of them. We've seen some on the ice tonight, including Luke Middlestead, Batchelder, and Bokey. So,
when you look at this list, I don't even know who wins it. You have five really good defensemen there. Middlestead, Nelson, Palatichuk, Parrott, and Pierce. Those guys are all very, very good D. You could easily give it to one of them. You could give it to one of the forwards as well. It's just kind of one of those years where it's, what do you like more? Do you like that defenseman that logs minutes and can provide offense? Do you like the speedy forward? There's candidates up and down there that would all be deserving.
And you know what I like about it the most is all these players probably had the chance to go play juniors, but they came back to play their senior year of Minnesota State High School Hockey.
They did, and as we've talked about throughout the tournament, this has been a different year and a difficult year, but they still wanted to come back and finish out their senior years with their friends.
Yeah, there's a nice display for Minnesota's Mr. Hockey. It'll be... Here are the highlights, starting with the only goal of the game happening in the first period for Eden Prairie.
Yeah, Jackson Blake is involved in it. Beautiful pass to Batchelder here. That's just a gorgeous shot. He did not have much to shoot at here. That's right in the corner. No chance for Tyson on that one.
I tell you what, the shot making here, upper corner's the only thing that's open. He just snipes it through. It's amazing.
Correct. And again, we talked about it, and we're wondering how long one line can carry a team. This is now 12 of the 13 goals they've scored in the tournament. And they continue to stay hot.
In a 1-0 game, the pressure goes to the goaltenders in the third period. We got a couple of good ones.
Absolutely. They, you know, not a ton of big tests for either goalie, but the ones that they made, when they were tested, they made the big save. This is the breakaway for Willis here, and he's kind of falling down it, and he just gets a nice job, just gets his toe on it to keep it up to 1-0.
Take a look at the stats. The stats are brought to you by McDonald's, owner-operators of Minnesota and Western Wisconsin.
Yeah, not as much offense as we were hoping for. It's been, I think they're kind of, as they say, feeling each other out, and they're, I'm going to look for more offense here in a second.
The third period of the AA State Championship game coming up from downtown St. Paul right after this. Right throughout the puck for the third period, we get another check presentation from Friends and Bank and Trust.
At Friends and Bank, one of our core values is supporting our communities. With the Franson Forward Grant Program, we're excited to support schools across the state. I'm pleased to present Graham Area High School with this $5,000 check to benefit their science program.
Hi, we're from Graham Area High School. Our science department was fortunate in being selected to our Franson Forward Grant. With me, our science students who will benefit from the new technology and equipment made possible through this grant. Thank you, Franson.
That is my alma mater, Graham High School. Proud.
probably took some classes and threw some spitballs in a couple of those rooms there. So congratulations to them and France and Bank and Trust for being a partner here of our broadcast and our coverage of the tournaments on 45 along with Lou Nanning. I'm Jim Erickson, ready for period two, 1-0 Eden Prairie.
We saw Kimball Harmony, go to the fourth line, which was very interesting because his team does come from behind all the time, and I think he's just trying to get everybody rested for a push later on if they need it. And that was very interesting. By the way, it's a good-looking fourth line.
And there you see on the top line, you got a man by the name of Cam Bakke, a Mr. Hockey Award finalist. And they'll give that award. I was wondering in the Class A game, that they will do that virtually on Monday at 4 o'clock. It's usually on Sunday after the state tournament, but it will be Monday virtually. And, of course, the Wild helped to put that on as well. Back to live action here, second period, opening minute. Eden Prairie, they're in the white uniforms, and Lakeville South in the dark. South trying to dump it in and forecheck, and instead, here comes the slip stick handling Jackson Webb through center, and then he ran into a stick, goes down at the blue line. Lucky, it looked like it was his stick, and that's going to be a tripping call, and Eden Prairie will have their first power play of the game.
Well, you're looking at the penalty right here where Jackson Blake is taken down, and then, earlier in the telecast, the beginning of the telecast, is Lucky's going off. We talked about Eden Prairie's power play. It was great all year, but in the tournament thus far, it's scoring at a 43% percentage. So we
45 seconds left in the penalty on Lakeville South. Lucky comes around, Holt trying to pinch, and instead it's going to be sent the other way. It's England. Comes in on the backhand, shoots it in on Hayes, who had cut down the angle, but then England gets it right back. And he's a good penalty killer, one of the better penalty killers, according to Coach Kibohami. They're coming into the tournament, and once again, we're going to have to start deep in his own.
Well, he's quick and smart, and he pressures the puck here like he's doing right there. And he's going to the puck here.
He knocks down Holtz. That gives him Holtz a chance. Out in the middle, shot just wide. England was all over the place on that shift on the PK, and then another one. They still didn't clear, and it's in the glove of Hayes.
Well, it looked like Lakeville South was on the power play. Eden Prairie was killing penalties because all the puck control was by Lakeville South. A great hit by England there. Takes the puck. Now he goes to the far side. He gets a pass and just misses the far corner. That's got to give Lakeville South a lot of life right now.
Still for help then. Up and around by Tyler Johnson. And Johnson then is able to force it out back to the blue line. Langfeld's Green Prairie. Cross the line. Langfeld still with it. Looking over far side, Harlan. Then he throws it in, looking for a carom. Harlan ends up with it. No look backhand centering pass. Intercepted by Lakeville South. Hoover's come back. Lucky gets to the line. He's met there immediately by a double team. Langfeld is coming in along that wall with Bakke. Centering pass just out of the reach of Aaron Holtz, who's in the scoring area. Turned the other way. It's Harlan. Harlan for Jorgensen. There's his shot. Blocked to the side by Tyson into the corner. All along the end wall. Here's Brown. It's been a while since we've seen that top line three Prairie, so
they're looking to power play.
Yeah, so that's right. Up to Langenbrunner and then over to Brown. Back outside the far circle, Feinberg. He's outmaneuvered by Bakke. Bakke trying to get those skates to go. He's hauled down. Is there anything? Maybe just a fall down there, Lou. No whistle. We play on. Brown. Lost the handle, it slides in on Tyson, and he will cover up.
Well, you had a little action in the Lakeville zone, but they really weren't getting any shots. Good forechecking, Wayne Perry. They were able to come up with some pucks, but they did not get any opportunities, and that's what the Cougars from Lakeville wanted to do, keep them away from good shots.
Getting pushing out to center, Jake Casey. That grew in Jake Casey, Cousins on the Eden Prairie team. Third set of D seeing some time here for Eden Prairie. Backhand off the pipe, middle step. That was just a half, kind of a backhand shovel. Very heavy. It was on the post and forced wide and then back the other way. Lakeville South trying to answer. They left the reset here at center. Willis, but Willis lost it. Hope comes in. It's a delayed offside. Eden Prairie needs to touch up. And that allows Walensky to come through here for the Cougars. Kane's in, comes in unencumbered, gets up the puck in the shot, and the glove save. No
playoff save Hayes.
Well, and you see the backhand earlier. It almost seems like it must have been deflected because that thing dropped. Yeah, it was deflected right there. Dropped down, deflected by Blake. And then Jack Molinsky comes back up ice, makes a rush, and Hayes makes a save and holds on for the faceoff. Holt already had his arms in the air. He thought that puck was going in. And earlier, you see Luke Smith said that him taking the shot from the blue line got deflected by Blake.
The tournaments on 45 TV are brought to you by TGK Automotive Specialists. We want to earn your business by earning your trust. From the XL Energy Center, the final state high school hockey game of the season. Physically distanced fans here, upper deck.
A lot of room up there. They've done a good job of physically distancing.
Jason Hagen, our cameraman, way up top. When you apply for that job as cameraman way up there, you got to make sure that you don't have the fear of heights. So I'm assuming Jason doesn't have that.
Well, that's one thing I wouldn't do. One of the things that each of these teams could do better is don't be taking no-look passes in the offensive zone, destroying the rebound.
Gunderson shot in on Hayes. And the Eden Prairie goaltender, the senior, makes the save. Are you surprised we haven't seen more goal scoring in this game tonight?
No, I'm not. You know, you got two good defensive teams. You got two good goaltenders. And you're going to have a mistake almost to get a good shot on goal. But
off the glass, back to Langenberg, knocked down by bodies, and then sweeping out of Luloff. Hit some bodies, and then out by Lakeville South, and a race for the puck the other way.
Clearing in front of them by the defensive Lakeville South.
It's that third line, Doms getting to the puck. Eden Prairie able to clear, and then it comes right back to Doms. Didn't have numbers down the middle, and they toss it up to Coring for the Eagles. Boring though, stolen back. Very persistent there is Ashton Dobbs. Just a sophomore on that third line. He's got a bright future. Loose puck out in front. Big kick pass save by Hayes. As it comes back out, and that was Dobbs who he denied.
That was a save of the game thus far. I'll tell you, it looked like he had an open net. What a save. Hayes was in right side.
Best grade A chance of the night for Lakeville South. Here they come back again. Gunderson through center. Lost the puck. Played back in by Eden Prairie. Jorgensen's line out there now. Gunderson for Lakeville South. Off the glass. Brett Johnson. And Brett Johnson and Mason Johnson defensive pairs here. Separate pairs. Shot. Save. Picked out. Nice save by Tyson. That again, the rebound was there. Lakeville South able to clear it out of the scoring area and then out of the zone. Coming back is Xander Billings. He took a hit. And still able to force that here to the near side corner. Steered around Johnson for Eden Prairie. Lakeville South now able to do something here on the forecheck. Eden Prairie having a hard time getting out. Just as I say that, they get it up and out of the zone to Jorgensen. Here he comes back and tries that move around. Then the loose puck ready for it. Hartle. And a couple of saves there by Tyson. And the save of the game brought to you by Mining Minnesota, committed to sustainable and environmentally responsible mining in Minnesota.
And that's the save of the game. It's right under the blade of his stick. A great chance for Doms, who's already got an important goal in this tournament. And as you see, Hayes comes right across, and it's right under the blade. By the way, this past shift was maybe one of the best Tyler Johnson's had in the tournament. He just was a motor up and down that ice, defending, offending. He was just very effective in this last shift.
You don't see as many skate saves these days as you did in the old days because the goaltenders are always down and the pads usually cover the skate, but that was a skate save.
He's thinking about that one right now.
Oh, my. So close to making it 1-1. 7:20 left second period. Still 1-0 Eden Prairie. Jackson Blake coming in with Holt. That was behind him. Batchelder has it again. Goes right back to Blake, who walks across the line. Maintains the zone. Up in. Aaron Holes is the first one to it, but then it goes right back to Holt. And the shot to the point. Langenbrunner. And another save and control by Tyson.
Well, you see the defense of Lakeville South turn in front of the net as we look right here at a big hit by Middleton, who does it all. He's had a great turn on himself. And one thing you look for every time that puck goes deep and he gets it, he's able to skate it out. A very good puck carrying defenseman going to the University of Minnesota. He's having a terrific tournament as one.
Tried to get a breakout to work. Eden Prairie messed it up at the Eagle line.
And the Eagles come back to the center circle. The 20th anniversary Wild logo. Nice move to the line by Langfeld. Shot blocker side wide. Off the glass and back out. Lucky. Oh, and Lucky got hammered by Langfeld. Big center ice collision. Now Bakke's got it. And his shot is blocked. Middlestad got in the way of that.
Two great plays by the defense. Langfeld's with a big check right at center ice and a nice little flip up by Middlestad. Here's the hit right here. And look where it is, right at the red line. That's one thing that the defense, especially Perry, are meeting the puck carrier early outside the zone. You see Lucky get hit there by Langfeld. It's really a great way to play defense.
Good job by Lucky. He didn't even go down. He stayed on his skates. That kind of collision. Eden Prairie zips out to center. Holt. That's out.
That's one thing I hate to call him an AFS anyway, because you know he's fast when you stick.
He didn't even go down, he stayed on his skates. That kind of collision. Eden Prairie zips out to center. Holt, that's onside, even though he's poked away. Jackson Blake could hold it in, and now the whistle to begin eventual hand pass there.
Yeah, you never call that hand pass before. That's one thing I hate to call it a hand pass anyway, because you know, you're fast when you're sticking your best off the shoulder. That one actually hit in the forehand before the fellow hand pass. I think the game would be speeded up if they allowed hand passes all over the ice. I don't know why they don't.
That's a revolutionary thought, though. We should get a petition going, huh? Shot right side, kick save Hayes. Where's the rebound? It ends up to the Eagles. They try to clear, but here comes Bakke down the slot, and he jammed one in on the Hayes pad.
Right on the doorstep, I'll tell you, there's no question that this period he had the tougher saves to make, even when the shots were different.
Macho to create some space. He had Blake also in tight, pushed by Bakke. Now Lucky, got guys tangled up. We're going to get a penalty. Aaron Holtz goes down with Macho. Top X, and they score! It's Bakke! As Lucky and Bakke, their teammate, dumped at center ice, they kept on the rush, Lou, and we're tied.
And that was a beautiful goal, a great passing play. You know, you got Lucky and Bakke combining on that play, a pass across the goal, and no opportunity at all to stop it. You see Lucky using his feet, that's inside with a nice move, passing across. Bakke with a wide open, and what a great move right there. Boy, that was a nice move by Lucky and Bakke. Nothing to open up to put it away. We got a tie game right now, 1-1 after the top line. The next for a beautiful goal, one of the prior goals you're going to see. Even though he's being checked, Bakke had the presence of mind to keep that stick on the ice, and he put it away.
And there was no penalty on that hit. Those two players going down at center ice.
I didn't think, why would they call it?
No, it was more of a collision.
It was a collision.
They were just sharing the same spot. Two bodies in the same spot. They both went down. And this ties this game at one. Eden Prairie going back to work here. Brand new hockey game. Bakke getting the goal. It's 27th of the season. Third of the tournament. Brand new game. Nearing 3.5 left to go. Second period. And now bouncing the step. Childer has it now with 48 seconds remaining in the period. Lead pass for Holt. Back to Batchelder. Went by him. He plays it off the inboard. Has it on his stick. Turns and shoots. It's knocked down. Lucky has it for Bakke. That one escapes his stick off the far side dasher. Blake comes back in now. End to end. Block. Tried to shoot it through the screen. Rebound Lucky. 25 seconds left. And back to the far side, Middlestad comes across the line. Eden Prairie getting a change here and off the save. It's Lawson and just wide. Brown had some net to work with there. Back up the Langfeld shot block and sent down by Lakeville South. We'll get an icing here and a faceoff. But it's 6.8 left.
Well, you see EP with a good chance right here, and it looks like checking by both teams is stopped, and that Brown just misses the far side right there, right on his forehand as he gets that loose puck, going to the short side, misses it. But both of these clubs a little lax in each of their zones, and we had some opportunities that were missed, because this game right now should be 2-1 for one of these two teams, because they each had that kind of opportunity to score.
If Brown is a right-handed shot on that right wing, he scores.
Yeah, and I think. By the way, he made the right play there. Here you're going to see the goaltending coming up. There's 2.4 seconds to go, and I think, yeah, Lee Smith is going to. That's a little scary because you can't score for 2.4 seconds. Maybe 1.5 I might try. Especially Baron will see with that draw and they get it done, but they're not going to.
No. It ends up at the side of the net as we get the horn and the end of an entertaining second period here at Eden Prairie at a 1-0 first period lead. Lakeville South Blue did exactly what they needed to do in the second period, tying this game up.
Exactly, and I have to say the Cougars from Lakeville definitely had the edge of play there. Certainly had the better opportunities. Hayes had to make a number of good saves to keep this game at 1-1. Even though the shots are 23-17 for Eden Prairie, it looks like Eden Prairie had a lot of shots that period. The majority were from the outside or from the side. A great period of play by Lakeville South. They look a little fresher right now, so Eden Prairie's got to be aware of it. You know, they got to be fresh when they're on the ice.
Don't go anywhere, Joe Schmidt and John Cole. Coming up next on 45 TV. On 45 TV are brought to you by Education Minnesota, the voice for professional educators and students.
In that second period, we're tied with 1 period to go in the state championship game. And Johnny Cole, I guess this is the way you kind of try to dish it up, right?
Yeah, I mean, we kind of saw this coming. I don't know if we saw 1-1 coming, but we saw a tight game going into the third. As we joked before the game, if it's tight going into the third, this is right where Lakeville wants it. They've had, in their last three games, they've scored 4 goals in the third period each game. So I expect them to come out and score.
And you know that Lee Smith is telling them that in the Eden Prairie locker room right now. He said, watch out, these guys have been good in the third period. Let's take a look at some of the highlights from this second period of action. We had some great goaltending by Zach Hayes, Eden Prairie.
This is the second time he's made an incredible toe save. He made one in the first on a breakaway. I can't believe that didn't go. That was a beautiful pass and a great save.
And he is doing it. And doing it well. But Lakeville South was able to get on the board.
That's a ridiculous toe drag. As they say, get your popcorn ready. That's a must-see toe drag coming here. Walk right around him. And then have plenty of mind to slide it back toward Ibaki. That was a beautiful goal.
It certainly was, and Bucky's not going to miss that opportunity to put it away. That tied the game at 1. Your stats are brought to you by McDonald's, owners and operators from Minnesota and Western Wisconsin.
Yeah, you could get rid of score, and you probably guess it's a tie game, right? Shots are close, scoring chances, everything is close. I mean, I'm sure the coaches are telling them it's 1 period for the state championship. This is the type of thing you dream about as a kid. This is why you do the summer workouts. This is what it all comes down to. It's going to be great.
I would guess at this point of the season, there's no such thing as fatigue. You got to go out there good enough. We got one more period, 17 minutes of hockey coming up right after this on 45 TV.
Mackley Auto Repair, we offer full service on all
One with Lou Nanny. I'm Jim Erickson getting ready for the third period. Lou, this is your 57th tournament. How does this one rank? Top 10?
Well, you know, one thing about them, they're all different. They're all memorable. And I have to tell you, they just are exciting year after year. You just get pleasure out of being here.
Certainly, as far as being a little different or a lot different, this one certainly is going to rank, with having to deal with the pandemic and COVID-19 and everything here this year. But, just a salute to everybody to get this turn. We didn't know if there was going to be one. We didn't know what the season was going to be like, and we've been able to get the tournaments in here this year.
I love the fact that all three tournaments, or four tournaments, were played this week, and they got them in, and everybody's really been very lucky to have participated in this. This was questionable, as you know, for quite a while because we didn't know how the COVID was going to be affecting high school sports all the way along. But boy, it was pulled together, and we're the benefactors because we're getting to see great hockey, and I expect to see a great period now. I have to say, thus far, the second and third line of Lakeville South Cougars is out playing the second and third line of Eden Prairie, which could be a key because they were key in the victory.
Yes.
Of the Cougars earlier, and near the end of the first period, the top line in Eden Prairie looked a little tired to me. They got to get refreshed and be ready to play.
Lakeville South had to come back against Moorhead. They had to come back against Wayzata. They have come back here to tie this one against Eden Prairie. If you're just joining us, the Class AA Championship game, Lakeville South in the dark uniforms, in that maroon, and in the white uniforms, and of course, is the Eden Prairie Eagles.
got to just make certain he gets that puck out of the zone quickly, because Eden Prairie feasts on turnovers. And if they can get some turnovers in the opposition zone, then they got problems. We've got a man down here in the wing, and they can...
And to the corner here on the near side, it's Batchelder.
Batchelder, a key player. I hope he's all right there. Eden Prairie.
The near side wall, but he was hidden from our view.
Yeah, I hope that his leg's all right, because he's not able to stand so far. This kid has had a fantastic year, and he's had a superb tournament.
Yeah, he has the only goal here tonight for Eden Prairie. His sixth of the tournament, 34th of the season. He's up. Need a little bit of help heading back the other way.
Well, it looks like it's a leg, which, you know, you hate to say this, but it's better than the head, because right away they'd have to go to concussion protocol. But you're hoping that he's able to recover from that injury. And you look at a concerned coach, Lee Smith, mm-hmm. and team. This kid has definitely had a wonderful career. He's going to be going to Colorado College, as we said earlier.
Lee Smith, a former Wilmer Cardinal with 500. That win last night was his 531st career victory in 28 years at Eden Prairie High School.
Well, the one good thing right now, Batchelder has not gone to the locker room. He's standing in the room. So
if he's out for any period of time, that's a big loss for Eden Prairie. As we go back to live action, Phil South with the puck. Jack Malinsky, fine defenseman, leaves the puck. He makes good decisions. Plays the puck deep. Eagles come back the other way in their transition. Lou Holt, along the line, they've got Brown right now centering Blake and Holt. They cough up the puck. Now it's Lucky. His centering pass was out of the reach of Mason Johnson all the way back. And then it's popped up. Here comes Holt, but coming out to meet it was the goaltender, Tyson. Ooh.
Oh, good play by Tyson. That looked very dangerous. It was a race to that loose puck, and Tyson won it.
Tyson made the decision when he needed to. If he hesitates at all, he might be hung out to dry there by Drew Holt. So good, confident play by the goaltender, Tyson, as the puck is back in the Lakeville South zone. Reversed around by the Eagles. John Harlow trying to get to the boards to hold it in. Trying to flip it out, Malinsky. But there's Harlow once again, good football player. Hands it over, top of Jorgensen's stick, and Brown took a swing on it, intercepted, no doubt for Lakeville South, up but not nearly enough to get out, and Brown throws it back in deep for Hartle. And they just blow with trouble shifting there for a while. And it'll end up with Jorgensen at center, the center circle will spin around and dump it in.
Another dip of Eden Prairie's going to have to be shown. With a guy like Batchelder.
Yes, Jorgensen. Now, sometimes when one of your stars goes out, though, sometimes the team tries even harder. More guys pulling on the rope. Next man up mentality as Hartle comes in. Shot, juggling, saved by Tyson. And he's able to just hold on and force the faceoff.
Yeah, good thing he did, because right on the doorstep, you look at the race we saw earlier. Tyson came up and just was able to get that up. It was loose puck because Holt was looking at getting in there alone to make a move. It's Tyson again, make a good save to get that piece of it.
And a clean win by Aaron Holtz. Lakeville South's breakout pass, though, misses everybody with the icing.
It's Tyson again, make a good save to get that piece of it.
And a clean win by Aaron Holtz. Lakeville South's breakout pass, though, misses everybody with the icing.
Aaron Holtz, as we said earlier, will be going to Colorado College with Batchelder. That should be interesting to get two quality centers like that, if they're going to both play the same position, be teammates, or one might have to switch to a wing. One thing, if it goes as it's gone to tournaments, one thing you always want is Aaron Holtz taking draws.
CC is going to have a new goal shot from straight away near the blue line. Out the bodies out in front. Guess he's back out there. Batchelder. Little step. Aaron Holtz. Pass Batchelder. Back to middle step. Hitting bodies. Knocked down. Gunderson. Lakeville South. Back with Lucky. Wanted back door to Pocky. Into the skates of Gunderson. Lucky comes back in the center circle. Although he could grab it. It's back the other way. And he just shoots into the zone. First wide. In the road. Chris crosses with Blake, throws it up the middle, and it's going to split the PB net, and then fell back.
One thing I think Eden Prairie guys could do a little better is use the blue line, use the point. When you're coming around their net like that, you're getting points wide. The points are wide open. You might want to put it back there and let them put it on net. They can see the play in front of them. They know what to do, and you got a good outlet that way.
Gunderson had it at center, but he loses it to Blake, who pickpockets him. Blake then got pickpocketed with a poke check. Then it comes to Brown, and a shot. Lakeville South player got a body in the way of that, but Eden Prairie then sends it back in deep to that Lakeville South zone. Spun around, and Belinsky tries the near side. Off the glass, off the glove. Langenberg couldn't quite keep it in. Brown has it, though, and they come in onside with a Langeville Ryan Burke shot on that right side. It's in the glove of Tyson, as you see number 10 there, Phil Feinberg, with a look in on Tyson.
You're going to see a block shot here. This is something that you might have noticed on the statistics before, how well Lakeville South has been blocking shots, and we see one there, blocked again. And that one, you know, we've had a few times we've talked about Dundas, and we blocked that again. But the defensive, Lakeville South has been blocking a lot of shots.
Such a big part of the game, no doubt about that. Trying to tip it out was Doms. And instead, going to around to Feinberg. Helped up by Willis, but not out. The puck out in front just went wide. They try a long pass, it'll be icing out of the reach of England.
Well, you'll see the tip again. That shot from outside, you watch Brown right on that 21 right there. He just deflected that past the corner. Good opportunity there for Eden Prairie to go ahead and have that tip to the foot to the left. Great pressure by Eden Prairie in the last trip and a half of the four check, keeping the puck in there, moving it around. Through. They shoot a lot from the point.
And again, off the draw, kicked around. Blake shot through a screen, then it hit a leg. Lucky with a rebound. Won't give him a couple of shots. It's off the glass and down. It's going to be icing again here on the Cougars. That's a good indication of the forecheck here for Eden Prairie. We get to the game summary brought to you by Preferred One. Achieve your best self at Preferred One Health Club.
Great play from right here, your back shot, and put him up 1-0. And look at this one right across. Lucky to Rocky. The post run yard, 1-1, 12-10 to go here in the third period.
Eden Prairie face off, back to Langfels. In and around. Langfels comes out to center.
And you've said that a lot tonight. Langfels has been lugging that puck out of the zone quite a few times and doing very effectively.
Patch Elder left the game with an injury earlier this period. He's back out there the last several shifts. Loses the puck though to Doms. What can he do with it? He gets behind the defense and he just grazed the post.
You can hear it.
Ashton Doms. He is ready to burst out. He's been playing well. Does have a goal here in this tournament. He's got it again. Right, the loop into the zone. Tipped out by the Eagles. Back at the line, Willis though couldn't maintain any possession of the puck. Gunderson puts it high in the air to the Eagles.
Good check there by Lucky because it looked like Blake was going to be able to take off. Lucky uses his body very well to separate him from the puck.
Horning swings it around from the neutral zone. Batchelder lets it go by because he only's got Blake there, but instead intercepting Lakeville South. Big side here at center across the line. Porter lost it. They got to get back on Blake, and they do. Batchelder then lost it at the line. They'll have to touch up and reset in the neutral zone. Batchelder, perfect timing after Holt came out of the zone, and Batchelder being bothered goes down. Stripping the puck away, Porter on that check.
Good play by Porter, coming back, working hard, as he said, stripping him on the puck.
England in low, middle staff, starts it up, Drew Holt. Gets those legs at Churney, comes across, and a shot. That was right at Tyson's blocker, and he fights it off.
First line just going over for a change now. They got to watch. You're getting down to 5:45. And a couple of times there, they didn't come back too hard. And the defense had to do a good job to keep Maple Grove, I mean, Lakeville South, from getting on the opportunity.
What a battle tonight for the Class AA Championship. 5.5 left. All tied at one. And the Cougars fumble it down. Icing. Let's catch our breath here and get ready for the last 5:25. Here's that last chance. Doms, boom, off the pipe, tied it up.
Students in extracurricular activities earn better grades. have better attendance.
Growing for essential metals in America and around the world. But who will meet this demand? If Minnesota doesn't lead, mining will occur without protections for workers or the environment. Minnesota has some of the largest deposits of copper, nickel, and cobalt in the world. Minnesota can do it better, safer, and grow mining jobs here at home.
We support mining in Minnesota because it'll be a slam dunk for all Minnesotans.
Who will be the hero? There you see Aaron Holtz. He's got the potential in this 1-1 game.
He's done it a lot. He's greeting these draws. I mean, I have to tell you, though, we're talking about the top lines all the time. But right now, watch out for Dom's Willis and Portno, because they have had a very good game. Hit a couple of pipes and worked hard. They're dangerous for Lakeville Sun.
Eden Prairie wins it at the point. Middlestad, a shot deflected. Batch Evelyn in there battling behind the net for the puck. It comes up the wall. Hockey tried to fight and get it out of his zone, but Eden Prairie holds it in. And it's right back in deep again. Malinsky will try the far side this time, and Lucky's got possession out to neutral. Comes across the line, long rink wide to Bakke, shoots it off the wall, loose puck! After the save by Hayes, Lucky tried to get to it, the Eagles clear it out of there, and now they carry it out of the zone. Langfels off of a body. Middlestad will have to go back and will retreat, circle, look up ice, and bring it to the neutral zone.
That Langfels made a great play to get that puck out of the arm's way because there was a wide open net sitting there.
Middlestad with a backhand shot, basically just to get it on net.
Look at this chance now. Watch 24 in front of the net. That puck's just all alone right there. It looks like Lutke's going to have a wide open shot there. But the reaction, very, very good there from Langfels. They're not going to wait. Lutke was just waiting to put it home.
Langfels, a whale of a game here tonight for Eden Prairie. You look at those players, the coaches on the bench, you got to kind of take a break and go, man, it's great to be a part of this, and it really is. Like Bill South, centering pass from below the icing line, intercepted, and Newloff brings it in for Eden Prairie. Carries it all the way deep. Gets it up high to Corrin. Here's his shot. That's off bodies in front of Tyson.
Newloff, who worked hard and made a couple of good rushes, made an excellent play there, getting it back to the blue line for the shot.
We are nearing 4 minutes left in the third period. Eden Prairie with a good, sizable lead in shots, 30-18, but still, it's 1-1.
And this is no 30-18 game, I'll tell you that. Nick Gustav has played very well. Scoring chances are closer than you think.
Chance for Eden Prairie here to get organized in their zone and set up back behind the net. Mason Langenbrunner. Long rink line, Ryan Horing, tip to center. Gunderson sent in for the Cougars, and he'll leave the ice. Forechecking Aaron Holtz. Here comes Lutke and Bakke as line mates to join him. And it's Lutke who finds it at center. Ends up on this off the skates of Langenbrunner. Then play ahead Horing. Holtz could clear the zone. Bakke ends up with it. Wanted to send it up through, but it's covered nicely by Corrin.
So forecheck there by Holt.
Here comes Holt. He's got Blake way on the other side. Holt trying to go all the way around. Wanted to find somebody on the near wing. Bakke ends up with it. Lucky here for Lakeville South. Lucky to his defenseman, Johnson. Johnson in Bakke. Bakke in deep. Batch over battles for him. He's going to end up with it. Here's Jackson Blake. He's usually got the puck on the screen.
They better not stay out there too long on that top line. That's one thing I think they've done a little too much of. It could be caught off their tire.
Almost got caught with that long pass. That almost didn't have enough mustard. Could have been intercepted. Batchelder a shot. Where's the puck? Tangled up in the near side corner.
Now's the time you got to start looking to change for that line.
Bakke. Lucky. Glides to center. Here comes Bakke, one last burst here on this shift. Keep the outside of the pipe. Rebound for Langfels. Going to leave it back behind it. He can't center. Lucky all alone out front. A shot with Hayes down. Hayes got a piece of it and went wide.
And so does Holt come back. A great back check by him.
Gunderson's blast at it. Batchelder, he's feeling that. He is shaken up. Holt back out to center. That's twice now. Batchelder's been shaken up in this game. This time he'll get to the bench under his own power, but he's feeling that. With now under 2 minutes.
minutes left to go, 140 to be exact. John Hartle for Eden Prairie, a 1-1 game. State championship dreams being realized here tonight. But who is going to realize those dreams? We've got nothing decided here at this point.
Boy, this has been an even game all the way through, going side to side, length to length, just as both teams working hard, looking for the one opportunity to put this game away.
Intercepted, Willis carries it below that icing line. He's being bothered by Johnson. Up to the point, quick wrist shot wide by Mason Johnson.
Three different Willis to get that back to as we get down to 1 minute.
1 minute left to go in the third period. 1 minute left in regulation, 1-1.
Not surprising at all. Think of this all night long. Just two good teams here.
Feinberg, Brown. Feinberg finds the defenseman, Mittelstadt. Shot on the body's out. Ball kicked around. And out of the danger area, Mittelstadt takes a shot that almost beat Tyson from the near side wall. Eden Prairie keeping up with it here. Mittelstadt from Feinberg, back to Feinberg. Back to Mittelstadt, 22 seconds left. Langfeld shot, hit a leg. And Gunderson will force it out. Lutke, 14 seconds left. Lutke, Prairie gets back to Lutke shot. Blocker's side, it's the glass. Lutke keeps it in. Both teams in a push here trying to win it in regulation. But it looks like we will be going to overtime, and we are second straight night here, overtime in Double A.
Not unexpected, not unexpected. Both of these clubs very, very well balanced. They work hard. They move the puck. Here's the post earlier right here. Bakke taking a shot. Boy, you think about those as this game winds down. Scramble here in the corner. Looks like you're going to have an opportunity for a free shot in front, and just when it looks like it's going to be put away, couldn't quite get good control. The goalie comes across to make a good save, and the hold back checks to also help out right in front of the net. So two even teams, and now it's going to be who gets the best opportunity and puts away. These goaltenders have not given up anything. You're looking at the captains of these teams, each of the coaches telling their teams, the one thing you got to do now, you got to take defense first. Take care of your own zone, the rest takes care of itself. So you got to make sure you play very strong in your own zone.
Overtime is next for the AA Championship on 45 TV. There's your bracket. We're in the final part of that bracket. We're far right. You can't go any further right on that bracket. This is where the season ends. 1-1 in overtime. And, of course, let's flash back, Lou. We were in overtime last night.
Yeah, Eden Prairie. Fortunate to come over with a win right here. A strong Maple Grove team battling all night long. Great play by Holt right over Batchelor. They had a wide open net, and that's all she wrote. And that's what each of these clubs are going to hope to do here tonight. You've got to be very, very strong in your own zone. You've got to back one another up. You don't take gambles. You know, they got to be way over 50% before you go for a puck. If you're a defensive trying to pinch, for instance, you got to make certain on your passes, outlet passes. You've got to relieve pressure. You don't have any time to take, to give blind passes, especially in your own zone, to give blind passes.
This season, Lakeville South, 1-0-2 in overtime. Eden Prairie, 2-0-2 in overtime. Of course, those two wins last night. And the other one was in the section final against Minnetonka. These teams have played. This will be their third state tournament game to go overtime. They played the third-place game in 2017. Overtime, Eden Prairie win. Of course, that quarterfinal game that went triple overtime in 2019, won by Eden Prairie. So an eight-minute overtime session. It's Drew Holt. Who's got more energy? Blake. Toe drive shot. The flex out of play.
Well played defensively. Blake with a move. He likes to pull that on the inside. Drag it past your defenseman. Stuck right with him. Puck got deflected up. This line for Eden Prairie has seen a lot of ice in this tournament. Not just tonight. So when they change, they got to make sure it's a smart change. Not getting caught up while Lakeville South, for instance, is going into the zone.
Keep in mind that these teams did get a day off that Class AA didn't normally receive. They used to play Thursday, Friday, Saturday in a normal year. Of course, it was Wednesday, Friday, Saturday this year. Up to the line, Langfeld holds it in. Just joining us here tonight, coming back home, and got overtime hockey for Eden Prairie's in the white uniforms, dark uniforms, Lakeville South, Lutke from way out, scooped by Tyson, Hayes. On that end of the ice now here for Eden Prairie.
I think you're going to see a lot of face-offs if shots are taken from far and the goalies can handle it. They're going to make certain that they don't leave any loose pucks around, plus it helps getting changes. They want to make certain that they also have fresh guys on the ice. Both of these clubs, you know, playing the high pace all night long, so fatigue is always a factor.
Setting the line going back, they win the draw. Shot to Johnson. There's way too much traffic out in front. Cleared out Eden Prairie. Luloff will chip it in. Being chased in by Gunderson. Then the body of Doms in there to free the puck up, and that allows Lakeville South to come up from center. Willis goes wide of the wall. Dumped in. Doms. Johnson at the point. Back in low. Couple of pokes at it. Comes to the point. Gunderson. Gunderson, Willis. Skips it over to Johnson, and a shot. Hayes has it.
Whoa, right in the doorstep. I'll tell you, when you see Novak just standing there, it's a good thing Hayes held on to it. This line for Lakeville South has been very good. You see the shot coming from the far out of the blue line, and Novak right in front trying to deflect that. But Novak, England, and Stone King are working hard in there, and they made a good play getting it back to the blue line and going through the front to try and deflect the shot.
There's a patented faceoff win by Aaron Holtz. Johnson slaps it into the corner. Lucky to Aaron Holtz. Oh, and that deflected, and Hayes went down and got as wide as he could on the ice to keep that one from sneaking underneath.
Hayes has been tested a number of times tonight as you look at Lucky right there in front. But he made a good play there because that deflection was headed right into the net. Into save and frozen.
Eden Prairie, 31 shots on goal. Lakeville South, 22. Another Aaron Holtz faceoff win. They immediately get the puck deep in the net. Below that icing line, they went corner to corner. Aaron Holtz, they wanted to go to Lutke on a nice pass from Hockey. The pass was deflected. Lake had a stick on that. Good smart play.
Good defensive work by Blake back there.
Langfels, Hockey hanging on him, forcing him again to turn back deep below that icing line. Holt will take the outlet pass and carry it right through the center circle. Holt comes in. Every time he brings the puck into the zone, I think people get on the edge of their seat because he comes in with speed.
That's exactly right. He really comes in with speed. He's dangerous.
Aaron Holt zips around the defender, carries it out front, crashes to the net, and Hayes ready for the crash.
What a play by Aaron Holt. You know he's way wide, and he wants to go to the net, and he's going to be defended, but he took it all. He took the puck, the man and everything right towards the net here. You see him cut to the inside around Middlestead, right to the front, trying to put a backhand in there. And Hayes again with another good save on Aaron Holtz as he busts right into the net.
Then he somersaults over the goaltender.
Right on the doorstep was Bakke looking for a loose puck.
Another faceoff in the Eden Prairie zone. Eagles this time get to it in the corner. Did Langenberger find a way to exit the zone? He can't. Little back door there for Willis off of his stick. Finally corrals it back behind the net over to the far side. Now it's Novak up and around on the reversal. Doms is into the city to Willis. Then it's Novak. Quickly tried to fire a centering pass, ready for the interception. Johnson takes it, and Eagles clear, but only to the red line. That's way up over the net again, and several rows up. Another face-off. This one will be in the neutral zone.
Oh, good work, because that line, they've been dangerous throughout the tournament. Willis and Doms, just sophomores. Ordinary junior, that's a good-looking line that will be returning here for Lakeville South Cougars. And they continually put pressure on every time they're out there. They work hard, and they can throw that puck around.
Lakeville South may be their third consecutive trip to the state tournament. This is their first ever championship game appearance. Luloff, centers, and Feinberg is there. Got a stick on it, but it went up into the air. Back to Ray Willis for Lakeville South. Gaining the zone. The two number fives going in there. Coyne trying to take him out of the play. Then it centers, and Novak got tripped up. Loose puck to Langenberger. Off the glass to to center. Really appears Lakeville South has had the better of it here, don't you think, in the overtime?
Yes, they have. They put more pressure on
Ruloff. For Lucky. Long feed ahead. He thought he might be able to track down Dobbs there, but it was too far. And it's Middlestad who ends up with it. Tipped at the blue line by Ian Prairie in deep. Keen to chase it. Mason Johnson and Batchelder. Johnson gets the better of that. Pushes it up to the blue line. Lucky waiting for players to clear. He gives it in the middle. Nice little stick hand over here into the zone. Anderson gave it back to Lucky. Back to the far side. Centering pass denied by Ian Prairie, but flipped out into the benches.
Yeah, the Cougars are really moving the puck well. They're putting good offensive forecheck pressure on. They've had possession much more than Ian Prairie thus far in this period. And they just look fresh. They look fresh right now. Really more so than Ian Prairie.
Batchelder open the scoring way back at 5:56 in the first period. Lakeville South tied it in the second at 13:04 with Docky, and that is where we have been stuck ever since. Under 4 minutes left to go in the overtime. Batchelder comes across. Nice little move to the slot. Bodies. Oh, the goal is bouncing, and Blake couldn't get a stick on it.
Oh, that's as close as you can get, too. Great effort by Batchelder.
Back comes Lakeville South. Johnson's shot hit a leg, then it hits the referee. Batchelder behind his own net, puts it right under the stick of Lucky. Good soft hands, but then Lucky's pass gets tipped out to center. And Mason Johnson sends it right back into the Eagles. Little snap for Blake. Then tip it in like he wanted to. Lucky comes the other way. Lucky a little toe drag. On his shoot through Langfeld. Langfeld's got a piece of that, forced it wide. Middlestad comes back the other way. Finds Jake Jackson Blake. Near wing, back door to Middlestad, just out of his reach. Holt got a stick on it. Willis will bring it the other way for Lakeville South. Some into an action now here in the overtime. Willis. Shot, pass, save. And he somehow is able to keep that one from coming up the slot and becoming a juicy rebound. It's cleared by Ian Prairie. It'll be icing on Ian Prairie.
Willis has got a set of legs, boy, but here's Ian Prairie chance already. A great play by Batchelder with that shot right there in the net. Watch to the right of the net. That puck just bounces away from number 43, Jackson Blake. Watch this right here. Almost hit it out of the air into the empty net. Good effort there. And that's the one and only chance, I'd say, that Ian Prairie's had this period. But they're going to have a timeout by Ian Prairie right now.
Oh, so close.
Yeah, that's one thing that these clubs can do. Looks like one team's got the dominant edge, and all of a sudden it turns around because each of these clubs so skilled. They skate well, they move the puck well, they support one another well. And because of that, we're sitting here with a 1-1 tie in overtime. We'll make their goals again. Great play right here by Jackson Blake. Back to Batchelder. He puts a lead up for Ian Prairie, 1-0. And then the other top line, Lucky with an excellent move here across the blocky right on the doorstep. He ties it up, and that's where we sit, and we've been sitting for quite a while. And who knows how long we're going to sit like this, because these clubs just don't want to give up. And that's the one thing about a champion. They got great spirit, and these teams do have a great spirit. You look at the past champions here, Jim.
Yeah, fun run of non-repeat champions. We've had a different champion since that Lakeville North 31-0 champion. Their first championship, Lakeville South. Same town, trying to add a championship to their pedigree. And Monty Kubalami's got that program cooking right now. And not a lot of fans here, but the ones that are here, they're bringing the energy.
Yeah, that's for sure. It must be warm because they're not wearing many clothes.
Heat rises. They're in the upper deck.
Oh, that's right.
Heat rises, so you got to pull out the tank top.
Well, you got two teams here that only have one loss in 43 games between them. So you can't be surprised at this outcome tonight.
Drew Holt taking the draw this time. He's escaped to kick it to the half wall. Blakeville lost it to Bakke, who falls down as he shoots. Didn't have a lot of help there. Lakeville South really got back defensively against Ian Prairie, afraid of their speed coming back. Batchelder, Holt playing catch, want to go back to Batchelder. And that one stuck by, and Bakke with the puck. Drew Sutter gains the zone, trying to leave it for Lucky, but it never made it to him. Lucky now has it with Lucky to his left. Lucky in the middle, he's got a backhand shot wide.
That's a good play. One thing
seed. Oh, yeah, any shot could be the last.
Yeah, you can't. Just the receiving rush by Eden Prairie when Holt and Batchelder passed it back and forth. Somebody's got to shoot that puck.
Aaron Holtz loses it shy of the line. It's offside as Lutke possesses. And one thing here, when you're in overtime, they took a timeout. That was a team timeout, but the media timeouts and so forth, those are done here in the overtime, so you don't get the luxury of that.
That's right, and here we only have 1:50 to go in this first overtime period. And each of these clubs, you know, you start feeling fatigued. So when you get a chance, you got to put the puck on the net. Just hope something happens.
Riku Brown, face-off win. Langenberg brings it outside.
Yeah, he's getting a little bit too antsy right there. You got to make sure you stay onside. Let it be onside in places like this. And Lindelof's just getting a little antsy. Boy, he can fly down the wing. If he gets a puck of speed, he's dangerous.
When these men dream of a state championship, and they play it out in their driveway, I bet you it's always an overtime win, right? Somebody's going to get a chance to live that dream here tonight at some point in time. With a minute and a half left to go in this overtime, shot from the point, Langenbrunner saved Tyson. We probably haven't mentioned enough how well the goalies have played. There haven't been a huge number of grade A chances because of each team's defense, Lou, but when called upon, the goalies have been very good.
That they have. They've had some outstanding saves.
Willis, right side, Gunderson, that one bounced in. Novak almost thought about wrapping it and tucking it back behind the goaltender. Didn't quite have room to do that. Eden Prairie gets it out to center. Tipped again. It's Novak. Near side shot off a stick and out. Pouring good stick there on the play. Under a minute. 59.7 left here in the OT.
Great stick work by this sophomore. Watch number 5, Coring, just get the stick right on that puck. That was an excellent chance for Novak. Coring with a good stick just deflected that over the glass. And we sit here, 59.7 seconds to go.
Yeah, Holt taking the draws now, and Batchelder playing at the wing. Maybe they're not having Batchelder take draws here because of a couple little injuries that he had here tonight. Lutke trying to toe drag through on the wing. Aaron Holtz trailing. Lutke there. Bakke bumped off the puck. Middle staff behind the net. Comes away. He's got a guy on him at all times. Batchelder slip sliding his way through center, and he goes down. Stolen away, Malinsky. Over to the Lakeville South line, but not yet out. Now they do. Lutke across. 25 seconds left in overtime, number 1.
Excellent play by Malinsky, and that move by Batchelder. Great move. Malinsky recovered and just knocked him down.
Batchelder. Aaron Holtz from behind. Batchelder goes down. Mason Johnson ends up with a puck. And the play by Malinsky is intercepted. Here comes Blake. 6 seconds left. Trickling puck. Late kick saved by Tyson. Holy cow. Puck is back behind the net, and there is the horn. And we have played one overtime. We get a second overtime here at the XL Energy Center.
Boy, you want to look at that again. Jackson Blake just misfired on that one. And it looked like Batchelder with a rebound right after. He couldn't quite put it away. Just when you think there's not enough time to score, watch this play right here in the last action. Here he comes right here. A good shot by Jackson Blake would have been all that it took, but he fanned on it and he hit the rebound. So the loose puck came right back to Batchelder. Look at this. He's going to shoot right here. And just seemed to slip off the end of his stick. And, boy, Batchelder on the doorstep. Two of the guys you don't want to have those kind of opportunities have them. And neither connected, and that's why we're in overtime and going to another overtime.
Jackson,
great play by both of these clubs here.
Jackson Blake's shot got tipped and kind of slowed up, so it was like a changeup coming in on Tyson, and that almost handcuffed him a little bit.
Yeah, he never quite got enough on it. Just coming off the blade, and you know, look at the goaltender Tyson going out, very happy about it.
It is April after all. We're tied at 1, overtime 2 coming up.
Ferguson Tire is celebrating serving the greater Grand Rapids area for 100 years. A history built on providing expert customer services and providing one of the largest inventories of tires in northern Minnesota. Ferguson Tire Grand Rapids, where there's always a tire sale.
WDIODT Duluth, WIRTDT Hibbing.
We cheer for the teams
the families, the fans, and the local partners who bring the game into your living room.
The tournaments on 45 TV are brought to you by Friends and Bank and Trust. Real people, real results.
Championship Saturday has its second double overtime. Eden Prairie and Lake Vassal tied at one after one overtime. And Johnny Paul, we saw that Eden Prairie used their number one line a lot. Their legs got a little heavy there at the end. Can you recover during an overtime time? Can you get your legs back?
Yeah, you can, and Eden Prairie needs it, especially that top line. You could tell as the game has gone on, they are becoming more and more tired. I noticed a couple times during whistles, when that top line's on the ice, it takes them about 10 seconds to get off the ice. They don't take another stride the rest of the way. I'm exhausted just looking at them.
You know, these kids probably don't realize it, but the person who scores this goal will carry that with them the rest of their lives, the next goal.
And that's probably what's being said in the locker room. And I think they do know it. They're going to be rejuvenated. They're kids. They're caught up in the moment. And I think they understand, you know, how special this opportunity is and how cool it would be to get the winner.
So what's it going to take? Is it going to be a tip? Is it going to be a dirty goal? Is it going to be something clean? What do you think?
Who knows? I mean, we had a power play one-timer earlier in the day in second overtimes. It could be anything. I'd like to see a pretty goal just for everyone's sake. It'd be nice to see a pretty goal, but you never know.
Hey, we had a pretty goal in another double overtime game. It was our first game of the day in the single-A girls tournament. Proctor Hermantown with a win.
Yeah, Alyssa Watkins turns and fires on a nice pass, one-timer. She's going to carry, like you said, Joe, she's going to carry that with her the rest of her life. Great moment for her, great moment for Proctor Hermantown, and it's going to be a great moment hopefully sometime soon here for Lakeville or Eden Prairie.
Yeah, she'll be at her 50th class reunion someday, right? And they'll say, hey, remember when you scored that goal that won us the state championship? And they'll never forget this feeling. I mentioned it to you, it was 24 years ago. You don't forget it, do you?
No, it's just such a special time. Although when we won, it was earlier in the day and it didn't take two overtimes. They're going to celebrate. Whoever wins this is going to celebrate like crazy. But they're all going to sleep really well tonight. And, you know, we'll say this after the game, but none of these kids on the ice have anything to be ashamed of or to feel bad after this game. It's a cliche in sports, but it is too bad somebody has to lose this game because both of these teams on the ice here, they are deserved to be champions.
And that's the same thing we had last night in our overtime game. Same thing. It's just a shame sometimes that somebody's got to lose. Proctor Hermantown wins the girls' single-A tournament. Who's going to win the boys'? Double-A tournament. Boy, I'll tell you, it's going to be a fantastic finish here tonight at the XL Energy Center. Call your friends, call your neighbors. They won't mind waking them up. You got to see the end of this thing. It's coming up. We're going to talk about it on 45 TV. Let's take a look at the first overtime. Some great chances by both teams.
This is the best chance for Lakeville. South Aaron holds with it. This is a man's rush to the net. I mean, you talk about crashing the net and laying out for a state championship. That's how you do it. And that's a big-time save by Hayes and covers that rebound. That was a great chance and a big-time play.
And then Cody Tyson had a save with you also.
Correct. This was going Jackson Blake bad out of midair. If he just missed it by a tiny bit. There was a chance at that very end of overtime, too, where Eden Prairie let Jackson Blake walk in almost by himself, and there were two great chances.
The stats are brought to you by McDonald's, owners and operators in Minnesota and Western Wisconsin.
Again, you look, and Eden Prairie has a slight edge in shots with nine, but everything else is fairly even. Lakeville's doing a great job blocking shots. Let's just buckle in and get ready for another overtime.
Overtime number two from the state of hockey for the state championship coming up next on 45 TV.
In this place, a game like nowhere else, where team is everything. Together, we push. We strive. And sometimes, we fall. But here, adversity is an opportunity to make teamwork count when it matters most. Because together, we own this ice. This is orthopedics and sports medicine like nowhere else.
A group of unions will be handing out 2,600 boxes of food down at the Beck parking lot. This event is part of the U.S. Department of Agriculture's Farmers to Families Food Box Program.
Labor had a great turnout of volunteers. It was such a big need for families in this community. Would you be willing to host it again? And Labor, of course, will step up and take care of that.
It was such a great feeling to be able to help them all.
WDIO, with you for solutions, with you for change, with you for life. Be part of the solution to create change.
For a winner, really. We're waiting for a winner here. 1-1, Lakeville South and Eden Prairie. Just saw shots of the two goal scorers here. Just two on the board for teams that have scored a lot of goals this season. Eden Prairie 5.3, Lakeville South averaging 6.2. And here we go. Overtime number two. This is a full 17-minute overtime period with a fresh sheet of ice. Lakeville South, Aaron Holmes trying to end it early here in the second overtime, a backhand wide.
Another one of those cuts to the net. Big, strong, good move. This one, maybe we'll put it away.
Cougars back at their line. Malinsky, that's up high on the goaltender Hayes, and he swats it out of their ping pong ball size. Stop. And it's back the other way. Eden Prairie, their first foray into the zone, down the slot. Lake lost it. Batchelder holds it in. It's a Timolinski for Lakeville South, who plays it ahead for Ehrenholz across the line. Centering for Bakke. High slot shot up high into the protective netting.
What a game Malinsky's playing. Here's a great chance for Ehrenholz. He cuts to the net again in the front. Tried to put it away. Just missed it. But back in the point, I'll tell you, you look at the bench when Ehrenholz was going in. They're anticipating some good news. Overall, the defense of Lakeville South has played their best game. And Walensky's just been outstanding back there.
Scoring for Eden Prairie off of their faceoff win in their zone from center. Thrown in. Feinberg tried to get there. They're able to hold it. Brown, Feinberg to the wing. Intercepted Lakeville South. The Cougars in the backhand flip. Willis went offside, then back the other way. Kicking on the play. Big hit by Willis. And out again to neutral. Minute and a half into the second overtime. And it'll be icing.
Just missed that and get the faceoff down deep in Eden Prairie zone. I think that Lakeville has been really good on faceoffs all the way through. And faceoffs are very dangerous when you're in the defensive zone. So who do you come on with? The guy that wins a lot of them, Ehrenholz. What a gentleman he's had in the face-off circle.
Our first game today went overtime, double overtime. Proctor Hermantown over Gentry Academy in the Class A Girls Championship 3-2. And there's their face-off win by Ehrenholz. Up to the line. Oh, he got by Malinsky to change direction there. The goaltender Hayes ended up wide along the end wall. Ehrenholz in along the end wall with Bakke. Winning the puck battle there, they play on Malinsky another shot. This one sails high over the crossbar. Jackson Blake couldn't quite get a stick on it. Now Batchelder has a chance at it. And he finds Drew Holt. Holt forced wide with Johnson back defensively. Oh, big shoots and rebound scores! Jackson Blake got the rebound! And Eden Prairie is your champion!
chance of that. But when you look at it, the assistant of Goldberg, Holt, Batchelor, his linemates, who were tremendous in the tournament, and just watch this, it just up the ice, Holt, who uses the speed all the time, and he puts a shot on the net, the rebound comes right out before the goaltender has a chance to react. Blake just pounced on that shot, put it in there. The goalie trying to come back and react, but you just can't. You can't do it that quickly. That was a big shot by Holt from the side. Blake just trailing the play, comes on the stick, so if anybody's going to get a free bird, it's fitting that the guy who was sensational all tournament long becomes the hero here with an outstanding goal. The play of the game, without a question in my mind right there.
And the play of the game brought to you by Minnesota Rusco since 1955. You know, there have been some rebounds like that, available rebounds that were kicked up the slot and were available, but each time they had been covered by the defensive zone team. This time it wasn't, and it decided the game.
It's just one of those reaction plays, and that's why it's never wrong to shoot and knock. And you look at the bench, Eden Prairie got to be ecstatic. Coach Lee Smith, who has more than 10 years in this tournament, and, you know, have two big losses in the finals here, back-to-back, so you can imagine the feeling he has. But that's hockey. That's what happens. That's why, and when you're in overtime, every time you get the opportunity, you got to put the puck on the net because you don't know what's going to result from the shot, whether it's going to go straight in, get deflected in, the rebound there, get cleared, whatever. But you have to take the opportunity to shoot the puck when you got it. They did it. Holt did it right there. And that man right there, Jackson Blake, puts it away. And you see a lot of mutual respect here. Lakeville South Cougars just played a wonderful game. I thought they were fresher. We were probably going to come and win it at the end, the way they were playing. But that's why you can never count the team out.
Yeah,
and you can never count a great play on it either.
Let's go downstairs. PA announcer Jim Carroll.
As we begin, please note individual medals will be distributed by school officials to the players at a later time. The 2021 state runner-up in Class AA boys hockey is Lakeville South High School. At this time, we ask the captains of Lakeville South to please come forward to claim your trophy. Lakeville South High School finishes with a record of 21-2. The 2021 state champion in Class AA boys hockey is Eden Prairie High School. At this time, we ask the captains of Eden Prairie to please come forward and claim your state championship trophy. Eden Prairie finishes with a record of 21-1-2 and is the 2021 boys AA state hockey champion.
Your 2021 champions in a season unlike any other. They hand Lakeville South their first loss all season. And Eden Prairie winning their third state championship, denying Lakeville South what would have been their first. And just a fantastic championship game, Lou. Again, anytime you go into double overtime, the anticipation, the angst is always there. And it was another fun one here tonight as it's time to announce our Herb Brooks Award winner.
What a great honor for Kate and Aaron Olson. What a great tournament this kid had besides everything else. So fitting that he comes away with something, because this guy was just, he's a marvelous kid. To win the Herb Brooks Award, you know that, and the way he played. As you look at Jackson Blake, Langfeld's going on congratulating Lakeville South Cougars, an outstanding game. They do play an outstanding game. They have a fabulous season. It's really tough, what we said last night, to lose when you play so well. But that's why we play the games. That's what makes it so exciting. And that's why we love to come to this tournament year after year and see who's going to win. We never know who's going to do it and how they're going to win. And it's just so superb to see the quality of entertainment that these kids provide us with.
And it was very entertaining, and I think the emotion
questions after the game even more intense here this year when you consider what these students have gone through with the hybrid learning, online learning. Things have been so different for them. And then to be able to let out that emotion that they've been wanting to let out for so long, they were able to do that here, Eden Prairie, enjoying a championship.
Well, I think the best thing that happened this year was all the kids were able to get this tournament in. We were so fortunate with what's going on throughout the season to have the opportunity to see this tonight. We're the benefactors, and yes, we're so happy that we had the chance to participate in it.
And thanks to everybody who also was a part of it, watching online and certainly on 45 TV. And also a big thank you to our folks in the truck, producer Brian Monahan and director Patrick O'Connor. Thank you so much. Hey, our player of the game, we still need to get that in. Luther, driven to serve. Visit LutherAuto.com. Of course, he's Jackson Blake.
I wonder what it is. And I wonder who it is as you look at Jackson Blake. He won't sleep tonight, that's for sure. This guy's got a great future ahead of him. He's a wonderful hockey player. He's extremely gifted. And he just comes game after game, and produces.
Yeah, so congratulations to him. Congratulations to the Eden Prairie Eagles. And again, thanks to our crew. Got a couple of names in there, but our entire crew, a grueling week when you think of the boys and girls. And many of them are going to be doing it next week with the boys and girls basketball tournaments also intertwined for next year, next week. That'll be a fun week of boys and girls basketball as we wrap up a fun week of boys and girls hockey. Congratulations to those champions. Lou, always great working with you. Fun, fun, fun.
And with you, my friend, it was a fabulous week again, and we see it and end it with an excellent shot by Jackson Blake.
And then yard sale. Rebound. Five hole.
Boy, can you just imagine the feeling he has? What a thrill to be able to score a winning goal in the state tournament that you'll live with for the rest of your life.
We got a pretty good idea, I think, how he felt at the time. He's going to go into the pile. The best part of that, he's going to go into the pile and decide, no, I'm going to keep skating out in the open, and we'll save the hugs for later. One more for you coming up. We'll wrap it up. Thanks for watching here. Joe Schmidt and John Hull. We return at 45 TV. Dwight Bianchi with the goal in double overtime gives Eden Prairie the state championship over previously unbeaten Lakeville South. What a hockey game, Johnny Paul.
It was awesome. It was a great tournament. You know, Jackson Blake was the best player in the tournament by far. It's kind of fitting that he gets the winning goal. And we talked about this before the last overtime, but, you know, whoever was going to lose this game should have nothing to be ashamed of, nothing to hang their head on. Lakeville played a great game and had an amazing season. They just didn't get the bounce at the end.
Yeah, Louie even said it. He said he thought that Lakeville South had the bounce, that they probably were going to win the game. It's just the way they had been playing in the first overtime.
They seemed like Lakeville as a team had more energy, and as we talked about before the second overtime, that top line of Eden Prairie, who basically did everything for them, seemed out of gas. And getting to that second overtime really helped Eden Prairie because those top five players could rest.
Yeah, and that was going to say that little halftime there helped out quite a bit. And not only that, just throwing that puck on the net. That's what you learn. And the guys talked about it up in the booth, too. You got to shoot in order to score.
Correct. And Jackson's going to get all the credit for the game-winning goal. But Drew Holt made a heck of a play coming down the right wing, and You're calling that a shot on goal. That's what, you know, that's a shot pass. He's shooting that for the far pad, hoping that that Tyson kicks it out exactly the way he did. You can't fault Tyson on it. He was doing exactly what he had to do. That's just a good play all around.
That's that rebound that he was looking for and he was able to get. So in Prairie, they obviously, you know, come into this season knowing that they had lost the last two state championships. They get in this game and it's down to the wire. The pressure was on.
It was, but they didn't seem to crack at all. I think we talked about this game and with them relying so much on that top line, playing overtime game last night, playing the night game on Wednesday. You wondered whether they were going to have enough gas to go, and they were definitely running on E, and that, like I said, that second overtime, the break helped them, and they came out, and to no one's surprise, it was Jackson Blake that got the winner.
Here are the final stats brought to you by McDonald's, owners and operators of Minnesota, Western Wisconsin.
We could look up and down and say it's an even game, which it was. This was just a great hockey game. Every kid on the ice poured their heart into it. You know, the Lakeville kids did not want to leave the ice after the game. They played a great game. It was well coached. It was well officiated. It was a great game all the way around.
You know, this tournament was different. There's no question. There weren't the fans here. Normally there'd be 18,000 fans here. But they were able to play hockey. They were able to name four state champions today. And that's a success.
It sure is. And for these kids, they're going to remember whether there was no one in the stands or whether there was 18,000 people in the stands. It took a lot of work with everyone involved. And like you said, Joe, it was different. No question about it. But when you see the smiles and you see the heartbreak on the loss, you see the ups and the downs, you see the stars being made, it was well worth it.
And we're taking a look at some of the highlights from some of the games in this tournament. A lot of great memories. You know, these kids, even who didn't walk away with the state championship, will remember this for the rest of their lives because they got to play on TV statewide. They got to be in the state tournament. They get to play with Minnesota Wild, gets to play. It was a good time.
It truly is a great experience. No matter how far these kids go in hockey, whether today was the last game they'll ever play, or whether they'll play 15 years in the NHL, playing in the state tournament, playing for your high school is a special experience, and the fact that these kids got to experience that is great.
And Johnny, I think we should mention Hill Murray and Centennial and Hermantown, the teams that, you know, did not get the total experience because of COVID. This was a battle of survival this year.
And your heart goes out to those kids. They want to be here more than anything. And to not get that opportunity is very, very difficult. So, you know, we're thinking of those kids, and it's an unfortunate situation for those three schools that it didn't work. But hopefully this is just a one-year thing and we can move forward.
Well, you know, the one thing that I think everybody learned is resilience. And you really have to be mentally tough to be a great hockey player. You know that. But this year they had to go dig a little deeper than normal.
They did, but these kids have been doing this all year. You heard Jim talk about they've been in hybrid learning, they've been in distance learning, they've been in-person learning. You know, they've been playing games. They've had games scheduled to play at 7 o'clock on a Tuesday night that get canceled because a kid on the other team has tested positive. So kids have been resilient all year, and this week was no different. And hopefully, as they move on in life, they can take lessons from what they've learned this year.
Yeah, it's just that resiliency definitely will help them down the line. And we saw a lot of kids who stayed in Minnesota to play hockey. Minnesota is the state of hockey. Playing in this state hockey tournament, you played the NHL, I guarantee you probably still think about the state hockey tournament as much as playing for the Gophers in the NHL.
There's something really special about playing with your high school buddies. You know, even college now is a lot different with the way kids are coming in and out of school, playing one year, in and out. When you go to school with a group of people and you're sitting with them in class and you hang out on the weekends, you're all going through the same stuff. It's pure. High school sports is pure, and that's what makes it great. Hopefully we can keep it that way.
And we see small schools like Dodge County. Gentry obviously is going to be around for a while. We should do these pictures and this video, this audio. Great crew. Pat O'Connor, our director. Brian Monahan, our producer. Monica Doyle, executive producer. You know, I could go on and on. Jimmy Erickson calling great games. They have the legendary Lou Manny up there. Just to be a part of it is really just a highlight. I know every year for me, and I know it is for you too.
It is. It's a special time. Just personally for me, I remember coming here as a kid, you know, to the old Civic Center, smelling the mini donuts and the clear glass, and when you see the kids in the stands now, it's something that they're going to remember. They're gonna remember their dad taking them here, their grandpa, or coming with their youth team. So it's a special experience, and I'm happy to be a part of it.
The legendary Minnesota State Hockey Tournament never fails to produce drama, amazing feats, and magical memories. And we had a championship Saturday today with two double overtime wins and some amazing celebrations. That's got to be fun. And look at that. Mr. Blake, we'll never forget this moment, carrying that trophy. They'll be bringing it back to school on Monday. We appreciate you joining us on 45 TV for the 2021 Minnesota State Hockey Tournament. Have a great night.